But check this out, okay? There might not be a Beyoncé if it weren't for Josephine Baker. She was Beyoncé before Beyoncé back in the 1920s. She was an original diva. She was the OD Beyoncé.
Wait a minute. Beyoncé OD?
No. Listen up, guys. Josephine Baker was born in Missouri in 1906. When she was 15 years old, the roaring 20s were in full swing, and the Harlem Renaissance was attracting talented African-American musicians, writers, and artists from all over the country. They wanted to move on up to the deluxe opportunities in New York City. Josephine made her way to Harlem and landed a job as a chorus line dancer in the 1921 Broadway show, Shuffle Along, which was the first Broadway show written by, directed by, and starring Black people. Josephine's signature move in the chorus line was to get laughs by pretending to be an incompetent dancer and then blow everybody away with her expert high-energy moves. This musical revue was a sensation with audiences of all races, and music legends like George Gershwin sang its praises. In addition to getting Josephine noticed, it launched the careers of singer Paul Robeson and composer Hubie Blake. But while white America was loving the black art, they weren't respecting the artists. Black talent had to use the back door at the white venues when they performed. And even the famous Cotton Club, which featured all black talent, had the infamous brown bag policy. You could only perform there if your skin was lighter than a brown paper bag. So when a talent scout from Paris offered her a feature role in the show there, Josephine said yes. She said she felt liberated from racism there, and soon she was a star. Pablo Picasso was a big fan, and Ernest Hemingway called her the most sensational woman on earth. But her fans didn't notice she was also a spy who helped take down the Axis powers in World War II. In 1939, she was recruited by Jacques Apte, the head of the French military intelligence service, to use her celebrity status to help gather intel on the fascist powers that were threatening Europe. Josephine jumped at the chance to help France, the country that made her a superstar. But spying is dangerous work. Josephine was trained in karate.
Eat foot, Führer.
And marksmanship. Josephine was now ready to spy. She would mingle with military officials and even heads of state like Benito Mussolini, who was actually a huge fan of hers.
Josephine,
She used her celebrity and charm to work them for intel on the Axis powers' plans.
I overheard some Gestapo in the lobby discussing troop movements. It's all here in this sheet music.
Magnifique. Countdown lady sings this song, Duda, Duda. A countdown racetrack 5 miles long, all the Duda day. I see. So the countdown lady is Hitler, and he plans on invading France on Duda day. When is Duda Day?
No, those are just lyrics. The intel is in invisible ink.
Of course, I totally knew that. Did you get any intelligence on the location of Italy's new munitions factory?
I'm about to. Hurry, hide, se dépêcher.
Entrez. Bonjour. Well, if it isn't Il Duce himself.
Josephine. You were fantastical. That banana dance, wow.
Ooh, why don't you book me on a tour of Italy? You know, I've always dreamed of performing at a brand new munitions factory. Do you have any of those?
Well, what was that noise?
Oh, just my puppy dog.
Meow.
He's a little slow.
After the war, French President Charles de Gaulle awarded her the Croix de Guerre, the Rosette de la Résistance, and the Légion d'Honneur, which is a fancy way of saying she was a total badass. Over the years, she adopted 12 children from all over the world, which she called the Rainbow Tribe, making her the Angelina Jolie OG. After the war, Josephine became an accomplished vocalist and returned to perform in America, where she fought for racial equality, putting pressure on clubs to desegregate, and was the only female speaker at the 1963 March in Washington, aka Martin Luther King's I Have a Dream speech. And then, in 1973, at the age of 67, she made a triumphant return to Carnegie Hall for a series of sold-out shows. See, now Josephine Baker is a true hero, and I just told you a story about her, which kind of makes me a hero too.